Hi, my name is Dr. Sandra Narayanan, and this is a PNI Minute. An ischemic stroke occurs 87% of the time, and it occurs when there is interruption of blood flow to an artery supplying the neck or brain. Most commonly, it's a brain artery that's affected, and it's due to a blockage or narrowing in the artery, and that results in lack of oxygenation or insufficient oxygenation. And initially, there can be stunned brain, which is not the same as damaged or dead brain tissue, but that is eventually what can occur if the artery is not opened up in a timely fashion. So that's an ischemic stroke, and that happens 87% of the time. A hemorrhagic stroke occurs 13% of the time, and initially the symptoms or signs can be similar, and that's why we don't always know at the beginning whether it's ischemic or hemorrhagic. Hemorrhagic stroke is due to bleeding in the brain. Bleeding can occur within the substance of the brain tissue itself, or it can occur on the surface of the brain, either spontaneously or due to trauma. It can occur due to tangles of vessels that are present at birth or are acquired during the course of someone's lifetime, or it can occur due to a weak spot in an artery that then ruptures, such as a brain aneurysm, which is the least common event, but by far the most deadly of all types of strokes, including hemorrhagic strokes. So that's one of the things we certainly look for if we see a certain pattern of bleeding in the brain. Because we don't always know whether a stroke is an ischemic or hemorrhagic stroke at initial presentation, although we may have a clue, for example, if someone presents with a headache or worst headache of their life, that tends to be more likely associated with hemorrhagic stroke than ischemic, but we don't always know. We have to rush them straight to a CT scan of the head without contrast. These scans are always done without contrast or iodine dye in the IV because contrast appears bright on scans, and fresh blood is bright as well on scans. So we can't have a situation where we have a confounding effect. And so the scans are done without contrast so we can quickly tell whether there's blood or not in the brain. If it's an ischemic stroke and the time window is right, first 4.5 hours, there are not other exclusion criteria like simultaneous intake of blood thinners and a lot of other inclusion-exclusion criteria, we may be able to give these patients clot-busting medications. So there's a lot of reasons why we have to be able to tell the difference between ischemic and hemorrhagic stroke. Hemorrhagic strokes are managed very, very differently from ischemic stroke. Sometimes both sets of patients may need to undergo emergency medical procedures, but for very different reasons.